What we had yesterday was a motion in the Senate for Richard Colbeck, the aged care minister, to have to explain his administration of his portfolio, particular reference to the Commonwealth support to and regulation of aged care during COVID-19. He's been under a lot of pressure lately. This is him forced to make this explanation in the Senate. He's been speaking for a few minutes now. Let's have a bit of a listen in.
I have been there. We have been there every step of the way, every day. We have not stopped planning, adapting and implementing. Mr President, I sat a couple of weeks ago with a friend who I hadn't seen for 30 years, who came to talk to me about the death of her mother 4 years ago and her concerns about the loss of dignity her mum felt in a residential aged care facility. I sat with her while she cried because she hadn't been able to address that issue for 4 years. She came into my office, we sat and we talked and we worked our way through what could be done, what will be done, and I tried to help her with her pain. And Mr President, it's those sorts of stories and those that we heard from the Royal Commission that drive me, that drive the government to improve the residential aged care sector in this country. Mr President, for us, this has never been about politics. The operation of the National Cabinet demonstrates that.
Order.
Labor can have their gotcha moments. They can ridicule and show disrespect to our most senior medical officials on the use of language at COVID meetings. It won't change, Mr President.
Order. Senator Colbeck, please resume your seat. Senator Watt, I appreciate this is a matter of some passion, but when I ask people to order by name, I do expect them to take a little break. And there's an opportunity to continue this, Senator Wong, but I can't hear the minister during this particular. Order, Senator Rennick. The minister has been asked to attend the chamber by the Senate. The Senate orders a minister to the chamber to make a statement. I'm going to insist that the chamber listen to the minister in silence because I have no doubt there'll be an opportunity for vigorous discussion afterwards. Senator Colbeck.
Mr President, Labor's games will not change a thing for the Australians who need our help the most. For me, this has never been about politics. I've invited the shadow minister to the table on many occasions. At any time she has asked. I've called many Labor MPs in Victoria to give them information on outbreaks that are occurring in their electorates so that they can assist their constituents with their issues. I've worked closely with my counterpart in Victoria, cooperating on many of the issues in the interests of senior Australians in Victoria and their loved ones, and I acknowledge and thank him for his cooperation. Responding to this cruel virus and its impact on communities remains my focus. And again, my sincerest condolences to all of those who have lost loved ones. Mr President, we are all ultimately responsible for the decisions made to protect the people we love the most. That is my focus. To deliver the plan, to keep senior Australians safe. I thank the Senate.